Now, your local weather with the KX Storm Team.
6:17. Welcome back to Good Day Dakota.
And now for your bad news this morning, Robert Sir joins
yes,
us.
That's right. Now's the time to repent because the temperatures are falling off a cliff.
Oh, no. So, all right. We'll try to find the bright spot while you give us the gritty
details
here.
Yeah. Good luck with that because I don't have a lot of good news. But some good news is we do have a couple nice days to go before temperatures do fall down. So we'll start with a look outside at the Dickinson Sky Cam. Not much traffic out there this morning. Still pretty quiet as people are still getting up and getting ready to head off to work or school. There's a single car making its way out on this Tuesday morning. It's not too bad temperature-wise in Dickinson. You're at 22 degrees. Wind chill, though, is a little nippy at 10 degrees because of that west wind at 13. Meanwhile, in Williston, you're at 24 degrees with 84% your humidity. In the capital city of Bismarck and in the Mandan area, it is 17 degrees with that wind chill of 8, and in the magic city of Minot, 28 degrees your temperature right now. A little bit windy up to the north. West winds at 17 miles an hour. Earlier this morning, we were dealing with some pretty thick fog. We had a dense fog advisory, but that was allowed to expire. Most places not dealing with the fog, thankfully, at this hour. Just a little bit of reduced visibilities. Linton, 4 miles. Mobridge, 2 miles. And up in Crosby, also 2 mile visibility. Temperatures at this hour, not too bad, still above average for this time of the year. Most places in the lower 20s, still a couple places flirting upper teens. Bismarck 17, Linton 19, and Harvey, you are at 18 degrees on this Tuesday morning. So coming up over the next couple of days, we will have clouds on the increase today. That's ahead of this Arctic front that's gonna bring us those much colder temperatures. We will still be able to squeak out one more nice day for your Wednesday before those temperatures really fall off as we get through the second half of the work week. We'll cruise through PrecisionCast now to talk about the sunshine that we'll have today and tomorrow. Just some high clouds filtering through the area, but you'll see those clouds on the increase with that Arctic front that's expected to move through over the next day or two. And then our next chance for precipitation will come on Friday. I think this is for southwestern sections, especially toward Dickinson, Bowman County. Williston may see a little bit of snow, but I think the best chance for accumulating snow will be to the southwest. Again, that would be early in the day on Friday. Then that storm that just misses us will morph into a monster winter storm for places along the East Coast. So if your travel plans take you out east this weekend, watch the forecast. Today, we'll get to 25 in Bismarck and Dickinson. Winds will be on the increase as we get through the afternoon. You can see gusting up near 25 miles an hour. In Minot, you'll reach your high early today, and then temperatures will drop as we go through the day to about 10 degrees by the time the sun sets. Temperatures elsewhere today will mostly be in the mid-20s, lower 30s to the southwest, where they'll have a little bit more sunshine, cooler up to the north. Those temperatures, as I said, will be dropping throughout the day. They will drop to 4 degrees tonight in Bismarck and Dickinson. Look at those wind chill values, 10 to 15 degrees. Below zero. You will be below zero for your air temperature in Minot. 3 below zero tonight. Just a frigid night in the Magic City. And here's a look at your extended forecast for the Bismarck area. You can see those temperatures really dropping off as we get toward the second half of the week. 3 degrees your expected high on Friday. 1 on Saturday. Watching those dangerous wind chills, 25 to 30 degrees below zero. The same applies for Minot. Those wind chills, 35, perhaps even 40 below zero in spots, with struggling to just get above zero on Saturday. So, guys, wouldn't be surprised if a wind chill advisory is issued from the National Weather Service later in the week because the effects from frostbite can happen very, very quickly.
All right. Layer up, layer up.
Getting back to the time of year where it hurts to walk outside.
hurts
your
my face.
Exactly.
Yep. That's right.
Keep it with us on Good Day Dakota. Still ahead.
Has the big lake frozen over yet? We'll take you to Lake Skakawea to find out. That's coming up next.
And learn why catching your next big one might have everything to do with your setup. That's all coming up.